This is a pre-built version of the application. So if we go ahead and run it. Now suppose we are in this sample space omega, and we have items that have different colors, and they are either striped or not striped, and they have different shapes. So the probability of omega is 1, and the probability of the items with blue colors event is 5 over 12. So we have 5 items that have blue color out of 12 items in the sample space. And this is marginal probability. So it is the same as this. So stripes can be anything, and shapes can be anything. And a marginal probability is when a subset of the variables is specified, and a joint probability is where all the variables are specified. And we can calculate this conditional probability. So given that stripes is true, then we want the probability where the color is blue, so it's 2 out of 6, which is 1 out of 3. The probability of both the color being blue and stripes is true, so those two. So 2 out of 12, which simplifies to 1 over 6. Over the probability where stripes is true. So 6 out of 12, which simplifies to 1 over 2. So we end up with 1/3. So let's try this. So given the color is blue, what's the probability of the color being blue? 1. So 5 over 12 divided by 5 over 12. So the intersection of color is blue and color is blue, which ends up being color is blue over color is blue, probability of that. So we get 1. And if we do the probability of the sample space omega, given that the color is blue, it ends up also being 1. So what we are seeing here is, given that we have this color is blue, what's the probability of the sample space omega? So it's always in omega. So when we have AND, we have intersection, and when we have OR, we have union. So we want the probability of the color being blue or stripes being true. So this is color being blue or stripes is true. So we have 9 out of 12 items, which simplifies to 3 over 4. The probability of color is blue plus the probability of stripes is true minus the probability of color is blue and stripes is true. And if we have disjoint events, then the intersection ends up being 0, so we end up with those 2. And the reason we subtract this intersection is because when we add those two, we have the intersection two times. We are counting it two times, so we subtract one of the times. Now, before moving to the code, let's go over a few items. So the sample space omega is the set of all possible outcomes of an experiment, and an event E is a subset of that sample space, and we have three probability axioms. The probability of the event E is between 0 and 1, and the probability of the sample space omega is equal to 1, and the probability of the unions of events E1, E2, etc. is equal to the probability of event E1 plus probability of event E2, etc., where E1, E2 is a sequence of disjoint events, and it follows from that we have that the probability of two events, E1 union E2, is equal to the probability of E1 plus the probability of E2 minus the probability of the intersections of events E1 and E2, where E1 and E2 can be non-disjoint events. And if they are disjoint, then this would be zero. So we come back to what we had here. And a sample space consists of n equally likely single element events, and the probability of any event A is given by the probability of A is equal to the number of elements of A divided by n. And this is the definition of conditional probability. The probability of A given B is equal to the probability of the intersection of A and B divided by the probability of B. I will start by creating a new project. And we need this jar from here to do fractions. So we go to properties and Java build path. And here we will have four classes. This one will be driving the application, so it will have a main method. And this one will represent an event, which is a subset of the sample space. And this one will contain the probability logic. And this one will represent an item in the sample space. Now an item will contain a hash map of features and a get method for that, and this will be initialized in the constructor. And example of features are the color, the shape, or if that item is striped or not. And this will be the data that we will be using here. So So this row represents a heading, and we will have our sample space here, and we'll populate it with data here. And this method does the display of the items in that sample space. And this method will pick up user input from the command line. And we will call those two methods from here. And an event represents a subset of items in the sample space. So it has this items array list and a get method for that. And this static method creates and returns a new event from a passed in array list of items. And this method handles intersecting the items in this event with the passed in event. And it returns a new event containing the intersection items. And this method creates and returns a new event containing items selected based on user input. And this method does entry validation. So we make sure that we're trying to get the probability of one of the headings here, either color or stripes or shape or omega. And this method will prepare and return a new event based on user input. And this method handles one of the sides when we have a union. So it creates a new event containing the event features that were specified by the user, and then determine the number of items in that event, and creates a fraction out of that with the length of the sample space. So this over this. And we will end up calling it from here. And it makes use of the probability of an intersection. This method handles the probability when we have givens. So given values and values. And finally, this method takes input from the user and calculates and returns various probabilities. And to do that, it calls the handle or entry and calculate probability. And let's go ahead and test run the application. So the probability that the color is green and the stripes is false is 3 out of the 12. So this simplifies to 1 over 4. And the probability that the color is green and stripes is false, given that the shape is square, ends up being 1 over 6. Since we have 6 items where shape is squares, and out of those 6, we have 1 where color is green and stripes is false. Or we can calculate it this way, by the intersection of all 3 divided by the probability of shape is square. And we can calculate this probability. So it ends up being 1. So this is where shape is triangle. And in both cases, color is green and stripes is false. And if we do shape is round, then we end up with 0. Since shape is round, it's here and here, and the color is green and stripes is false is here. And if we do the probability of stripes is true or shape is square, we end up with 2/3. So we have those those items. So 8 out of 12, and it simplifies to 2 over 3.